and showed me the way and showed us the way. And he made a way that was so different than anything that I had ever seen, anything my family had ever seen on my side. I've never experienced the blessings of God and putting your feet under his table and God just preparing the way for you. It's just amazing to see how God does those things in your life if you allow him. And, you know, we make Christmas about a lot of things. And trust me, I'm guilty of that too, of being so busy and caught up and I've got to get this and I've got to do this and family's got to be here. And it's nice to have all those things, but when you really cut it down, Jesus is truly the thing that we should be celebrating. And we've started this a long time ago. We don't open Christmas presents at our house. We'll do it before or after. Because of Christmas, how many's ever had a Christmas birthday? Or you've had your birthday, and everybody else got a gift but you. It's all, right? On your birthday, it's all about you, isn't it? Or should be. So we've tried to start doing that to just really promote that it's really not about the gifts. It's about Jesus and the gift that he gave to us. And it's more than eternal life. How many can say amen that God has provided for me in so many ways that I can't even begin to tell you. It's so amazing how God does that. So we're going to go to the Lord in worship this morning. And we're going to ask this morning if there's somebody in here and you haven't experienced that touch that Jesus can bring to your life. You say, well, I don't know about those blessings. I've never had him prepare the way. It's just as easy as getting a gift on Christmas morning. You don't beg for that gift. Your parents or whoever gave it to you, they are happy for you to have it. And Jesus gave his life for you, and he's happy for you to accept that gift of salvation. Amen? Let's stand to our feet and go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we just come to you this morning, and we want our worship to be pleasing to you today, God. And we say, thank you, Jesus, that you gave us the gift of life. And Lord, not just that eternal life that we get to have with you, but you, in so many ways, God, you prepare the way before we ever even know it. God, you guide and direct our footsteps if we just put ourselves at your table. So this morning, Lord, we've come to worship you and to lift up your name. And God, if there's somebody in here this morning, they've not accepted that gift, that salvation from Jesus. Lord, let your Holy Spirit touch their life this morning as we invite your presence into this place, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's worship together.
In every heart. this whole thing's about is Jesus. It's not for him.
Us breath to be glory and a reflection of His own image so we can shine bright to this world and we can make a difference. God didn't call us to just sit here and occupy. He called us to make a difference and be a bright light for Him and His kingdom. So let's sing it now. Let Him lead us. Our hearts, all the earth.
For this choir, they're anointed, singing powerfully. Next Sunday morning, will be our Christmas Sunday presentation. Next Sunday morning is an ideal time to invite friends and family to attend church with you. And I want us to pray that God's same anointing will intensify through this week for next week, that we'll be here ready to worship the Lord as we are today, lift up His name, that hearts and lives will be touched in the Sunday morning service. Would you stretch your hand in this direction? Father, in doing so, we're praying for all of us together. We thank you, Lord, for a people of praise, a heart of worship, not ashamed nor afraid to sing out for Jesus. We thank you we can sense the power of this message alive in our hearts today. Here in our midst, you're real. You're here with us. And I pray to God that you would shake us as a people and as a church, that we would be mindful that if next Sunday does come, the trumpet of God has not sounded yet. I pray to Lord this week we'll be reminded to bring the people with us, to invite the presence of God to meet us here again next Sunday, that the power of the Holy Spirit can fall, manifest in this house, and the true spirit of Christmas will melt hearts at the altar of prayer. Needs be met through the power of Jesus Christ, our Savior and our Lord. We pray your blessings in Jesus' name. Now bless these people here today, Father. Meet their every need. Minister to them in power. Be with Ted and Judith Anderson, brother and sister Anderson, as they preach at the Heron Church of God today. May your hand be extended to the nursing home. May your hand be upon Dorothy Otterson, Pat's mom, as she's in the Heron Hospital today. I pray that healing be in the house. The ministry of the Holy Spirit can have a freedom to flow. Touch and challenge our hearts, we pray. In Jesus' wonderful name. In Jesus' name we ask. Let's worship the Lord in one more song of praise, lifting Him up in praise and worship today. In Jesus' name.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior.
Join with us.
The song that is true. Freedom for humanity with a grace.
today. Amen. Praise the Almighty. Emmanuel has come to dwell with us, our Savior, our Lord, and our King. Amen, amen, and amen. Next week, I want you to invite people out with you next Sunday morning. They will be blessed. Amen. For the good job of the Lord the choir did today, let's give them a hand clap of praise also. Can we do that? Thank you, choir. Tremendous. Just